أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome once again to our journey through the Islamic months, where we are shedding a light upon what these months are telling us and on their deeper meaning, and how we are supposed to turn these God-given months into something we can work with. We've mentioned at the very beginning that these months were not given by chance, they were given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we come in the Jumada. Now, we already said that it means that something turns into something solid, that it's something hard, and so forth. Well, we have spent these first months in worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where we got rid of our egos, where we firstly said that we would focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, gotten rid of our egos, came to the conclusion that we are nothing. And then we went through the Quran, and then we went through the salawat, and now it looks like someone experiences that he ended up in a routine. And that's what a lot of people have. Like at the very beginning, you're very enthusiastic. You really feel the vibes of the worship. You harvest the fruits emotionally, spiritually. And then after a certain amount of time, yani it turns into a routine. It turns into something with you, which you don't yani think about anymore. It became an action. And this is when people feel that they are far from Allah, but in reality they are not. It is not because that feeling is gone that you are far from Allah. It is like when people get married, yani the very first 6 to 18 months, yani you've got these hormones which are released, and in order for you to become attached to your partner, so there are these different hormones which are being released in your body, and which gives you the feeling that you are in love. Now, I mean, that's when you want to stay in the same room, you want to sit together, talk together. When you leave your house, you can't wait to come back, and so much more. This is the binding between the two spouses. And then at a certain moment in time, it will change. Now, this is after 6 months or 18 months. It all depends. And you will feel that fade away, that what people call the spark, the sparks are gone, right? So that's not true. But let's just look at this. If people were to always be at that same level of being in love with the butterflies in your belly, and you can't eat anymore, you can't sleep anymore, you cannot concentrate, you don't go out anymore, your social life stops, and so much more. If this were to carry on, you could even physically die. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes that away, and then that feeling in love, butterfly emotion, turns into loving and being attached to the one you love. So the feeling fading away doesn't mean that your love for Allah Jalla wa Ala is not as genuine as it was before. It merely indicates that you are now established in servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, these emotions are not the reason why you are worshipping Allah. You do not worship Allah in exchange for an emotion. Because whom are you looking for? Are you looking for creation, which an emotion is? Or are you looking of the Creator, who creates these emotions and gives them whenever He wants to and withholds them whenever He so desires? So if you know that that the time where you experience the lack of these spiritual emotions is no more than a test on the one hand, and the proof that you are established in the world of worship on the other, then you will not consider it to be something as a proof, proving that you are far away from Allah. That is where a lot of people give up. Exactly like a lot of people start to doubt their marriage or their love, or whether they are with the right partner. When this feeling of I am in love fades away, then they say, maybe I don't love my partner. But in reality they do. It's just the feeling which is gone. So not the feeling of love, but the feeling of being in love, that climax of your emotions which would be impossible to hold on to. So now when this fades away, It doesn't mean that you're far away from Allah, but it means that you need to renew your faith. Not renew your faith in Allah, but that you need to renew it. Yani you need to look once again at what drives you and at the reasons behind the things you are doing. Because at the very beginning, you know it's for Allah, you know because you want to find Him, you want to connect to Him. But then very often people perform certain acts of worship and they don't give themselves any reason anymore apart from I have to because it's obligatory. So they're not driven by any other emotion or motive. So now, barakallahu fikum, this is what the Prophet ﷺ is referring to when he said, like your hearts, they wear, yani they wear out, they get used. Now, exactly like your garments. So renew your hearts like you renew your garments, and do this by saying La ilaha illallah. So the month where you see that you are dried out, there's a drought, you feel like there's no spiritual rain being poured down upon you, then you just need to remove that cloud which is now hiding the sun from you seeing yani that which you are truly in need of. So the Prophet ﷺ made it very clear that yani you renew your faith by saying La ilaha illallah. So we come from the salawat to the tahleel. Yani the month of tahleel, it is the month of saying La ilaha illallah very often. You say La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la lahu al-mulku wa lahu al-hamd yuhyi wa yumeet wa huwa hayyun la yamut bi yadihi al-khayr wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. And all these different yani supplications which contain La ilaha illallah. Why? Because that revives your heart. It revives your heart, definitely. So being or feeling that you're far away from Allah doesn't mean that you're far away from Allah unless you sin. When you sin and you have an emotion that you're far from Allah, then usually it is because you are. Because they say if you want to know your value, then look at what Allah allows you to do. So when you see that you are indulged in sins and that you dive into the oceans of repulsive actions, then you know that you are turning your back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The problem is when you have this, as I said in the class of tafsir today, is when people are being afflicted, very often they sin. Because when a human being is afflicted, he wants to find distraction, distracting him from yani the hurting and the pain. And this is why very often a haram way to steal that pain takes temporarily that pain away. But then when one wakes up from the sin, he wakes up in a spiritual nightmare, where you see that doors have been closed and that the sweetness of faith has been taken away from your heart, that you see that it looks like you don't feel life, yani to be present in your body anymore. It even looks like you don't understand the Quran as good, that you, subhanAllah, it's the sin, the punishment of the sin is terrible. So this is why if you feel that you are far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then in reality, if that is due to you sinning, then most likely you are. But it is very easy to get back to Allah. And this is what Shaytan wants you to forget. Shaytan wants you to doubt that you can be forgiven. He wants you to doubt that Allah will accept you again. After having promised Him so many times and so often that you wouldn't do it again, and there you were doing it again. So now you look at yourself from a human perspective and you say, well, Allah will not forgive this, because if somebody would do this to me, I would not take him as a friend. I would kick him out of my house. That's not Allah. Allah is not like that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the moment you come back to Him, you will find Him close to you. The only one who was removed was you. Allah is always as close as He's always been. That doesn't change. But you are not. So this is why in this month, we want to renew our faith, barakallahu fikum, by saying a lot of La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah. Learn about Tawheed, read the books of Aqeedah so that you can see in front of you the magnitude and the beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being manifested in front of your eyes because of reading yani the books of Aqeedah and the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing nothing but which will end up in nothing more nor less than your faith being restored. And bi-ithnillahi azza wa jal, this is what we are going to do this particular month. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this beneficial. Ameen. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.